It's part four of Eve Einstein wishes Happy New Year to her descendants. I had talked about Edwin Birdsong. It's Edwin Birdsong, Eve Einstein's husband, that she wrote these albums with, Supernatural and What It Is. Okay, so, excuse me. It said, she said, it does seem that Edwin got the idea that women were whores, prostitutes, from his mother when he found out she had married Reverend Sidney Birdsong after she was pregnant, an unwed, excuse me, sex outside of wedlock, and that Edwin's not Reverend Sidney's child, that she sold herself to Reverend Sidney. This is Edwin's point of view. A mother's point of view, she's trying to make sure her kid has food and a place to live. And you know. So Stevie Wonder's mother, Lula Mae Hardaway, admits in her biography that she was a prostitute too, and her husband, Steve Wonder's father, was a pimp. So Stevie and Edwin had that in common. They see woman and Gary Bird. They see women as objects. You screw them, then pay them. Nothing to do with respecting or trusting, certainly not cherishing them. T. Michelle's mom told her to marry a rich man. Children do what you do, not what you tell them to do always. T. Michelle figured she'd help make her husband rich. She didn't even want to be in the position of being thought of as a prostitute. So she went, and her mother told her later in life, I'm so glad you didn't become a prostitute. And she'd think, what? You thought I would become a prostitute? My mother wasn't a prostitute. She worked a crappy, grueling, long-hour job and went and just so she wouldn't be a prostitute or kept a lady. You know, she was the most beautiful woman in the town and the smartest valedictorian. You know, but and she could have been the mistress of Dr. Pennell. He wanted her. Dr. Van Buren wanted her to marry his son. She wasn't for sale. So I followed her. I'm not for sale. So she worked. So Timothy worked hard as Edwin, worked as hard as Edwin, to help him get established. In the song, he wrote about her, I love you, Michelle, yeah, baby. There's a line that says, every time I call her name, she comes running fast and she knows what to do. Now, Ronald Drayton Head, Edwin's guitar player, thought I should be insulted by that line. But I wasn't insulted, it's true. Everything he needed to get himself a career, she was a, he was a student going to school on a GI Bill when she met him. From the time he played her a song he'd written, and she told him he needed a recording contract, she was answering his needs. She gave him feedback. He saw she believed in him as a songwriter. He got a recording contract with the help of genius negotiator, well-connected Michelle's husband in a parallel life, Johanna Vigoda. Then Edwin needed a lyricist. She had written plenty in her parallel lives as Shakespeare, Charles Dickens, Emerson, Emily Dickinson, Mark Twain, who wrote Huck Finn, Robert Frost, Hans Christian Andersen, Ayn Rand. So she wrote Edwin amazing lyrics. Norma Pinella, the program director of radio station WWRL, said Michelle's lyrics were movies. The middle-aged lady at one of Edwin's gigs shook her head and said, where'd you get Michelle, where'd you get such wisdom at such a young age? She asked the writing duo. With Edwin, some was from personal experience, the line he put in the song title, "When a Newborn Baby is Born, the World Gets One More Chance," was, "And the lie you tell, it don't miss his eye." I heard that and I wonder, where did I come from? Edwin's saying, "Mother, you said my dad was Reverend Sidney Birdsong. I'll act like I believe it, but I can look at my body and at Reverend Sidney's body and see that my body don't match his body. So where, nowhere, no how. I see you lied, Mother. The lie you tell didn't miss my eye." So when one of Edwin's fake babies' mother told him our son Sing wasn't his, Edwin forgot that he knew I'm a truthful person. One day he said to me, "You're hung up on the truth. My other mother, Ann Downing, now Robin Birdsong, told me you should know the truth and the truth shall set you free. She had an artist painted on our wall. It's all in me. I believe it. I run for the truth. I love the truth. I believe in the truth. So why would I lie and say the boy was his? Was his if it wasn't his?" So Jesus Christ being, as Charon Singh said, "The child is marked by the father. Singh has long, narrow feet, identical to his father, Edwin Birdsong. Singh's profession and skills are the same. Only Singh is a better singer and musician than Edwin because Singh worked practicing that guitar alone in his room so many hours his fingertips bled. He got tendonitis in his wrists. I'm playing the loud rock music made him deaf in one ear. His mother, Beethoven, composed symphonies being deaf in both ears. He put the piano keyboard on the floor where he could get closer to the vibrations. As Helen Keller, Singh's mother was the first deaf and dumb person to earn a Bachelor of Arts college degree. And Singh's grandfather, John Milton, now Milton Harris, Father Milton Harris, resident of St. Francis of Assisi, Residence 3, West Side of Manhattan, in Chelsea, New York, wrote his most famous work, Though Blind, Paradise Lost. As blind author Homer, Father Milton wrote the Iliad and the Odyssey, the epic poems that contain the foundation of the ancient Greek culture, one of the most enlightened in the civilized world. If you wonder what I'm doing, I'm free associating, just like Jordan Peterson does. Jordan Peterson is a genius, Nietzsche, Dostoevsky, Carl Jung, or Muhammad. Okay, I just saw his video and I said, he does what I do. He's free associating. The reason I know that is because Milton heard me, my father Milton, and he said, "Oh, you're free associating." I didn't know what I was doing. I was just being myself and expressing myself as I do. Okay, so this is what I'm doing. All right, Socrates, Singh's mother, is known as the father of Western civilization. Socrates said, "Know thyself." That is the reason Timoshel knows the identity of many of her identities in her 10,000 plus births. She has been guided through the journey of her soul by her guru, Jesus Christ, Charan Singh, Supreme Archangel, and Jason, and Jesus Christ being as Gurinder Singh Dhillon. Gurinder Singh Dhillon, B. Singh Dhillon. He's Singh Dhillon, Bob Dhillon. He can say, "I grew you, Guru, Mother Eve Einstein, World Uterus."